example, and I claim this is another application of your double number or double angle formula, okay? I have here for my given, tangent of 3x is equal to 2, and I told you I need to tell you where 3x is. So the way I say it here is that, suppose 3x, so notice here my theta or my alpha or my beta is given in the form 3x, okay? That's what I want to call it, alright? And I say that this angle 3x or number 3x or arc 3x terminates in quadrant 3, alright? So I think I have enough information to find the cosine of 6x, okay? So on your test, of course, all the formulas will be together, right? Okay, so then you'll say, well, gee, what do I use, okay? The key is really in to know what you have to use is you have to find the relationship between these two, okay? How is 6x related to 3x, okay? Well, right now I've just explained double number formula, so you know that, of course, you say, of course, it's double, right? Okay, so you know that 6x is twice of 3x, right? So you say, oh, okay, that's 2a. Correct? So it's 2a, a is 3x, okay? So therefore you say, okay, I need a double number formula for cosine, alright? Now which double number formula for cosine will you use? And you look at your shirt, no, you won't have a shirt. You look at my shirt and you say, what do I need? Which one do I use? First you have to look at the given, okay? So there are really three versions you can use. The first with cosine squared and sine squared, and you know the other two, okay? So, but the things you will use will have to come from the given. But the given is in terms of tangent. So, I guess it doesn't really matter what you use. Probably, it might as well just use the first version, okay? Which is what? It's the cosine squared of 3x. So now it's not 6x but 3x, right? It's going to be half of that number, okay? Because this is the double of 3x. Minus sine squared of 3x. But then how do we find these? Cosine of 3x and sine 3x. And the given is tangent 3x. You can use the same XYR. Oh, unfortunately I use x, okay? But you know what I mean, right? If you know tangent of 3x is 2, that's really 2 over 1, okay? This is really the sine over the cosine, right? This is sine over cosine. You need the R, right? Okay? So this is sine 3x over cosine 3x. But of course, you know by now that you cannot just say sine 3x is 2 and cosine 3x is 1. Where's the R that got canceled? So you have to solve for r, and r is going to be the square root of 2 squared plus 1 squared. I don't want to write the x because I might confuse you, okay? So this is the y coordinate over the x coordinate. We're solving for the r, right? Okay? So you get this, and I guess you get root 5, right? Square root of 5 is your r, okay? So therefore, if you have that, that means to say that your sine 3x, where will I write this? Your sine 3x is going to be 1 over root 5, right? So let me just do it here now. So this is 1 over root 5 squared. That's the sine of 3x because sine, oh wait, sorry, sine. That's cosine, right? The sine is 2 over root 5. And it's actually negative. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. This is very messy. Okay, let me write it here. So you have tangent of 3x is 2 over 1. And then we saw that r is root 5. So it's 2 over root 5 over 1 of root 5. 1 over root 5. We know that this is sine of 3x. This is cosine of 3x. But actually not quite, because we know that 3x is in quadrant 3. Technically, well, and correctly, okay, these two numbers should be negative because we're in quadrant 3 for 3x, okay? So we have these, okay? But the good news is, fortunately, when you plug them in here, you're squaring anyway. So if you forgot that detail, it's an important detail, but in this problem, you won't mess up because you're squaring a negative, okay? And then cosine 3x is going to be negative 1 over root 5, you square it. Notice I actually didn't bother to rationalize those answers because, see, I'm squaring. So the nice thing about this is when you square, you get 1/5 without the radical sign, minus 4/5 without the radical sign, and then you get the answer, 1 minus 4, negative 3/5. Okay, I hope I didn't make a mistake, but that's how you do it, okay? So I gave you the tangent of 3x. Well, why did I give this example? I gave you this example just so you know how to recognize which formula to use later on, okay? So 6x is double of 3x, so that's why it gives you the clue, the hint that I need to use a double number formula, okay? So, in other words, and I won't give you a full-blown example anymore, I'm just going to explain how to think of these things, okay? So let's say you are given a function, trigonometric function, let's say, of, let's say 2t. And you're asked to find some function, let's say g, of 4t. So you see the relationship, 2 and 4, right? 4 is double of 2, so 4t is twice of 2t. So you know, well, I have to use a double number formula, okay? So the f and the g there are like the functions, tangent, sine, cosine, so on and so forth, okay? If, let's say, I give you something in terms of, let's say, y halves, let's say that's the given, okay? It's a function of half a number, okay? And then I want you to find another function y, okay? G of y. Again, the key is to look at the relationship y and y over 2. How is y related to y over 2? In other words, always you look at the find, right? What you're looking for. What is this function of this angle that I'm looking for? What is this angle in relation to that, all right? And you notice that y, of course, is twice of y over 2. So therefore, that's how you know you will use double number formula, okay? Maybe I'll go back to this when I explain the next set of formulas, because there's another set of formulas that we'll add to these. Meaning, well, namely, here we're doubling the numbers or the angles the other way around, which I have in the back of my shirt, and then I'll flip my shirt over so you can easily see the formulas, are the half number formulas, okay? So when you do your test, I think end of the month, okay, you will have to be able to recognize, is this a half number formula or a double number formula? So that's what we're going to talk about next, how to do half number identities or formulas, okay?